Well, listen, just before the break, obviously, Crookie was ranting about Newcastle and the really bad situation that's happening there at St James's Park. Darren Ambrose, you played for Newcastle. I mean, what are your thoughts on the state of the club and the job that Steve Bruce has done?
Yeah, I've spoken about this before. I think it's a terrible situation for the football club.
Do you want Crookie's rant music?
This ain't really a rant. This is a...
Well, do you know what? I'm going to give it to you.
Go for it.
No, we don't have it.
We ain't got it. Right. No, look...
Oh, we have got it.
I do like it.
Go.
To me, Crookie, now, I agree with everything you said, really. It looks like the players have given up on Steve Bruce. Yep. It does. I think they went out against Brighton and accepted defeat. I think they didn't seem to have a game plan. One shot on target against a team that is 1 point above you, which is a massive, massive game, is unacceptable. I think you don't want to say sack the manager. I don't think you ever want to see someone lose a job or willingly lose it. But he looks and sounds like a broken man. I think a change of manager is needed. Problem is, I think the owner doesn't care at all for the football club. I think I've said before, the style of play is awful. Me and Crookie, we watched the West Brom game, and for me, it was one of the worst games I've ever watched, I think. And you've said the same with the Brighton game. In my opinion, the fans deserve more. I think they deserve, when they're allowed back in the stadium, they deserve to be watching Premier League football and not Championship football. But at the moment, I think they're not sleepwalking towards relegation. I think they're hurtling at it 100 mile an hour at the moment. And if they don't start picking up performances, it's really a possibility. And I think it'll be the worst thing to happen that can happen to the football club and the city. Two wins in 18 is not good enough. It's not good enough for anyone. And he spent £100 million, so he spent a lot of money. And I just think... In my opinion, I think it is time for a change of manager. If someone can come in and make this team play well, I'm not too sure, because I think the team look broken as well.
Yeah, and obviously there's problems in the dressing room, rifts with a number of key players. I think Matt Ritchie's played about 16 minutes since that training ground altercation. Andy Carroll, as I say, reacted very angrily to not being called upon when Newcastle really needed a goal last night. You've got Sean Longstaff, who obviously is someone who loves the club and clearly will fight for the badge, which I think a lot of Newcastle players aren't doing at this moment in time. It's not just on Steve Bruce that the players aren't stepping up to the plate either. And listen, it doesn't matter who the manager is. You need a certain amount of professional pride, and they're not showing that at the moment. But two really pertinent points you've made there. Steve Bruce is a boyhood Newcastle fan. This was his dream job. Well, it's quickly turned into a nightmare. And I think, actually, it's bad for his health at the moment, what's going on. You know, he doesn't look like a man who's enjoying the job. He's certainly not enjoying the scrutiny and the criticism that is coming his way. But Mike Ashley as well, if they do go down, I think there's every chance now, because Fulham look like they've got a bit of character, look like they can galvanise themselves, two things that Newcastle definitely don't have. This will be twice on Mike Ashley's watch that they've been relegated to the Championship. That shouldn't happen to a massive juggernaut of a club like Newcastle. I've only been to St James's Park once in my professional career, but it strikes me that as you're walking up to the stadium, it's like this crash-landed spaceship that dwarfs the rest of the city. Newcastle fans bleed black and white. They are so passionate about their club, and it's heartbreaking. It's heartbreaking what's happening, and it's heartbreaking, to use your words, that the owner doesn't care. Mike Ashley's only purpose is to keep Newcastle in the top flight, keep the TV money coming in, try and sell them for as much as possible. If they go down, it could be a massive implosion. I mean, look at Ryan Fraser. He's on a big old contract.
Do you know what, though?
He's one of the players who's not performing,
You said about, obviously, Andy Carroll, and he and himself, he looked frustrated because he wasn't used. But you're talking about a guy that scored 4 goals in 4 years. Now, I can understand from a...
But then why sign him? If you're going to sign him, get him on the pitch.
That's the biggest question. Because I look at 4 goals in 4 years, like, that's not prolific.
I think with Andy Carroll as well, not so much the goals, because, that's not good enough for a forward. We know that. He'll know that himself. But he gives them something different, Crookie. He gives them this option to if you're losing. When we watched West Brom, he bought him on for 20 seconds. I mean, 15, 20, half an hour into the game, Crookie, me and you was crying out for something different to happen. And he gives you that extra edge. And all right, he may not score a lot of goals, but you know, he causes problems, and it's something different as opposed to just sitting deep and defending a goalless draw constantly. It's just, it's not good enough.
I think the Dwight Gayle one. See, I'm quite a big fan of Dwight Gayle's, and I think if you play him enough, he will score enough goals. He always seems to pop up. If you give him a little run of games, he'll always score goals. And even though I think it was a couple of games ago, I can't remember when it was, he got some good positions, and it was just the final ball was poor, or he would have had a couple tapping. So, from his perspective, I can kind of understand the frustration. But I mean, the Andy Carroll one, as I said, 4 goals in 4 years. I'm thinking, well, hold on, like, if he was in like a rich vein of form, I'd be like, I can understand. So you've got to get him on, but. Obviously, if you're bringing him on for 15 seconds, that's not good enough. But then, as Crookie said there, I guess it's Steve Bruce's problem. He brought him in.
Yeah. Do you know what, though? You know, back to Mike Ashley. And I get a bit sick and tired of this. There was a big song and dance today because Roman Abramovich had spoken about Chelsea for the first time in 5 years. And Mike Ashley never speaks to the media. And I think he has to, you know, because he's a custodian of Newcastle United Football Club. Yes, he's the owner. But really, football clubs belong to the supporters. And Mike Ashley needs to come out now and speak to these fans who are obviously very frustrated, very upset, and tell them what his plan is.
Mike Ashley
doesn't
care.
What is the direction of travel for Newcastle?
He doesn't care, Mike Ashley. That's the biggest problem. He doesn't care. And I think if he did care a little bit more, perhaps they would have a change of manager.
Well, yeah, I mean, I don't think probably he doesn't care is probably the right words, but for whatever reason, he's quite happy with the way they're kind of going about their business. And for me, something's got to change there because it's a toxic environment and that's doing nobody any good. But as Crookie said there, I think his health is very, very important. Yeah. So for me, probably I'd probably step away because I don't know if I could deal with that kind of criticism that he's getting. But obviously, he's a pro man.
He's got 4 million reasons not to step away.
Okay, you put that aside. He's probably thinking to himself, he believes he can turn it around. If he does it, it'll be miraculous, but I think they're in a real difficult situation.